Hello, and welcome back to my channel. I am Gigi of GigiMadeIt.com. You know, the knitter, the blogger, and the yarn ho, coming to you with another episode. So, this week, I'm trying, guys. I have mail. I'll give you an update on Lewis, update on me, update on the cow, and yeah, that's it. It's gonna be a short one this week. You ready? So I'll start with Lewis. I've gotten quite a few of you to reach out to me asking for an update, and I tried to update as much as I can, but I'm happy to say that he is on the mend. He is feeling so much better. He's still a little weak, still a little winded, but he's resting better at night. He's not battling the fever as much. Actually, the last couple days, I don't think he's had a fever. So for those of you that were concerned about him, thank you very much. And your prayers worked. He's doing good. He's doing good. So that's the update on Lewis. Let's talk about mail. Yeah, let's talk about mail. I got mail.
Y'all know, I don't even remember the words.
I got mail. Come on in here, cause I got mail. You know, you wanna see my mail, cause I got mail. I got mail. So, you guys are familiar with Mason Dixon. Why do I always say their name wrong? I don't know why I wanted to say yards. Mason Dixon Knitting and their field guide. When they first sent me one, I explained to you guys that I didn't have a clue what field guides were. I knew they provided them. I didn't know. But I'm so very glad that they are kind enough to send me their field guides when they come out. This is field guide number 14, and it's entitled Refresh. This particular one is designed by Carol Feller. I'm not sure if you're familiar with Carol Feller. You should make yourself familiar with Carol Feller. There's four patterns in here: the transom cardigan, the twinning wrap, the trellis top, and the arcade cap. So with, does it say how much this costs? It doesn't say how much it costs, but you get four patterns in here. Okay, I will tell you that this piece on the back, I'm all about layering. So I am in love with this piece. And that is the trellis top. Yes, guys, close your eyes. Okay, open them again. You see this in orange, don't you? I know you do. I know you see it in orange. Orange, I have to make this. This is so nice. So again, you guys know I'm big on texture. There's nice texture in there. And you know, I love a layering piece. I like this time of year, a nice crisp, clean white shirt, and nice ability to either wrap a nice shawl around, or a nice poncho, or in that case, the top is like a poncho-ish type thing. Then they have this, I think it's called a wrap. Yes, this is called the Twinnings wrap. Again, talk to me texture, okay? Talk to me texture. So there's also a cardigan in here. More texture. You guys know a lot of texture on the sleeves. That's the transom cardigan, and then the hat is cool too. I like how the ribbon kind of explodes out to the hat. Like it. So that is field guide number 14. It's called Refresh, and this is featuring the designer Carol Feller. So check it out, guys. Mason Dixon Knitting. The other thing I wanted to share is my knit along ends on April 26th. So, what's the date today? I don't know what the date today is. But this is the fourth Sunday. So we got like 2 more weeks to go. And no, I'm not finished. I'll talk about that in a minute. But I gave you the date of my cow because Knit Collage is starting their cow the 27th, the day after mine ends. So I am going to join, and I am going to make... I'm going to have to put a picture in because I don't have my iPad, dear B, and I don't feel like getting up at this point. But I'm going to make the spring fling cardi for their spring knit along. And before I even show you the yarn, I'm still working on Mrs. Small to get some orange yarn. I don't know why she keeps playing with my emotions. But at any rate, I will be making the spring fling. Is it spring fling or spring thing? Does it say on this? It doesn't. I think it's spring fling cardi, but this will be the body of it, and these will be the accents. And I love how she takes the fiber and the material, and this is cotton. Yes, this is all 100% cotton. So I like how she takes the fiber and the cotton together to make a nice piece. It's a, I think I'm going to make the short sleeve version of it. So yeah, that's going to be my spring fling cardi. So if you were interested in joining the cow, there are quite a few other patterns involved. And what I love about it, once you buy your kit, you get access to all the patterns. And what Amy does is the patterns are exclusive to the cow for 6 months. So no one will, if they did not participate in the cow, they won't have access to the patterns until 6 months after the cow. So, you know, you'll be the first, if that's important to you, to be, you know, the first to have something or have access or, you know, complete a pattern. Then if you join the cow, you would be one of the first few to have access to that particular party. Okay, what I was saying is I do have an affiliate link that I will put in the down bar if you are interested in joining the cow. I would love if you use my link to purchase whichever kit you're going to get. So I'll put that information in the link, and hopefully I'll see you guys. She has a Facebook group for the cow, and I'll see you guys in the group. So that's the update there. Oh, let me show you where I am. I'm pretty much, guys, done with this. This is all I have left. I ain't no sense to me keep showing you the same thing, but she has grown. I haven't been knitting as much as I normally do because COVID has touched home. Excuse me. My godfather passed away on Thursday due to COVID complications. So it's been rough. It's been rough. I think the hardest part of it all is the fact that he had to die alone. So yeah, I'm not gonna harp on that, but that's why this is not done, because I start and I put it down, and
I've been digging through the crates looking for pictures to prepare for when we do have his memorial service, when we can all get together. So it's been a tough week. It's been a tough week. So where my knitting is normally my saving grace, not quite so much this time around. And I know it's because we can't be together. We can't comfort each other. We can't, all that. So it's been hard being me this week. So if you notice the absence of my normal sparkle, that's because it's like I didn't pay my electric bill. My lights are off. But I'll get back together, because although I'm sad, although this hurts, I'm determined to get to the other side. So having said that, you know, we're not out of the clear yet. I know so many of you are just tired of being in the house and want to get out. I get that. I'm not really, you know, one to go. I'm a homebody, for lack of better words. But I get the desire to go somewhere if that's what you want to do, right? I get that. But the flip side of that is, you going somewhere could mean somebody's life, right? You might be fine, but you could be carrying it. I think that is the scariest part of this whole thing. That somebody that looks absolutely fine could just be walking around infecting others. That's the scary part. So if you don't have anyone that you're doing this for, that you're staying home for, stay home for you, right? You don't want to get infected. You don't want to wind up getting sick. Last week also, there was my nephew was on the news because his school did pictures kind of thanking the frontline workers. And he said, his sign said, my mom can't be home because my mom can't stay home because she's on the front line. And they had it on the news. So I'll put a little clip of that in here. So stay home for all the little kids that are sacrificing their parents to save everybody else, right? So what do they say? 6 degrees of separation? And knowing that, I can't see anybody getting out of this untouched. It might not come in your house particularly, but it's in somebody's house, you know, right? Or somebody that you know, somebody that knows somebody, you know what I mean? Like, it's not too many layers to this, to where you will know someone that has been impacted. You will know someone that has lost a loved one because of this virus. So if all you have to do your part is stay home, please stay home. Please stay home. So I'm gonna leave it at that. It is Easter Sunday. So happy Easter if you're a believer. If that doesn't apply to you, happy Sunday anyway. Find whatever that is that keeps you afloat during this time. And yesterday on my Instagram page, I said I was giving myself permission to feel, because I'm a lot of things right now. The main thing is I'm not okay. I'm a lover. I'm a toucher. I need you to feel my love. And yeah, having to wait to say goodbye, having to wait to be with my family and love up on whoever is struggling, you know what I mean? And have them, you know, they're all worried about me because I'm the crybaby, for lack of better words. So they're all, you okay? You know, I'm fine. You know, I'm as fine as I'm going to be. He was 85 years old. Who's to say he wouldn't be going right now? But to know that he was pushed out of the door because of this virus, right? had this virus not happened, who knows if he would have been sick right now? Who knows if he still wouldn't have been around being the loving man that he is, right? So I pray that none of you have been directly touched by this virus, meaning nobody in your family, your immediate family, you know, whether it be blood relation or love relation, because in this case, this is my love family. These are my love relations. It's terrible, the amount of people that are losing their lives right now. And grieving is a horrible thing, but when you can't, you got to do it from a distance. You can't be there. You can't go to the hospital and see them. You can't hold their hand. You can't tell them it's okay if they're tired and they want to let go. Like, this is a rough time, man. This is a rough time. So I'm going to stop because I'm just not my normal self. And I'm okay with not being my normal self. I really am. But until next time, stay safe. Stay home. Stay home. And if you live in the East Coast, particularly New Jersey, New York, it's now required that you cover your face when you go into the food stores and stuff. Like, you got to take care of you. You got to take care of the people around you. You just got to take care. So I'll see you guys next week, hopefully in a better state of mind. Forgive me for coming at you less than 100%, but I felt like I needed to come and at least do this. And I did it. So, everybody have the best Easter Sunday that you can have on purpose. I know most people are used to being with their families, so it's hard to do Easter dinner and all that other stuff from afar. But do what you can. Most important, just stay safe. I will talk to all of you guys next week.